Hi, welcome to IEOR Berkeley. My name is Max Shen. I am a professor and chair for the Department of Industrial Engineering and Operations Research. I hope to use the next 25 minutes to give you a brief introduction of the department. And I do looking forward to the opportunity to meet with many of you face to face in the next semester. I assume many of you already know UC Berkeley really well, so I will just give you a really quick introduction. UC Berkeley is a world leader for innovation in high-tech, healthcare, design, and many other disciplines. Here we have a list of fundamental contributions from the campus. You can go to this website to take a look at the full list. Back to the department, we were founded around 1960, and George Danzig, who was the father for linear programming, founded the Center on Operations Research. And if you do decide to join IEOR Berkeley, you will have a chance to know what is linear programming, who is George Danzig, and what contributions we have made in operations research domain. UC Berkeley is ranked number 3 in terms of the number of Nobel Prize winners of any university in the world. And Berkeley is really a large, diverse public university, and we have world leaders in almost every area, every research field. In terms of the engineering school, we have been ranked in the top 3 for many, many years, and the department has been a top 3 IEOR program for the last 40 years. Besides IEOR, we also have top ranked programs on campus. Within engineering school, we have really almost every department is top ranked. And we also have a top ranked mathematics program and business school and econ programs. So what is IEOR? I assume some of you really know really well already. Some of you probably is still trying to figure out what IEOR can do. So I will give you a really simple equation formula, and then hopefully this will help you understand IEOR. I think IEOR basically equals to engineering plus measurement science. So we are in the College of Engineering, but we do management type of research and work. For example, we would analyze and help large complex systems such as supply chains, energy systems, healthcare, and financial systems to do better. So for example, in fact, Disneyland and many other major theme parks, their leadership teams, many of them, the members actually were graduates from IEOR program. So what they can do there is to help design the theme park so that the waiting time of the guests will be much shorter. Similarly, in a production, in a service area, you can design the facility so that the service will be faster. And then for manufacturing firms, we can help them design the production system so they can make things much faster and cheaper and with high quality. And more and more nowadays that many of our students has been involved in designing powerful algorithms in almost every industry. So that, when big data and machine learning become hot research topics, we can also contribute not only on the algorithms, but also on the decision-making side. And on the picture, this is Tony Xu. I still remember the fun time that I had him as a student in my supply chain class. So he's a founder for DoorDash, and he has been doing well applying IEOR knowledge to his company. So IEOR professors work on many cutting edge research topics in healthcare, finance, and supply chain. Many of you probably would be surprised that we also work on healthcare research. There are a few professors in the department are actually doing cutting-edge research in healthcare. For example, Professor Xin Guo have designed the machine learning algorithms to detect eye disease, and her algorithm has been one of the best in the whole world. So I will give you a little bit more examples of the research and the jobs that we can do after you graduate. And we also have several professors working on energy systems. The goal is to design a better energy system so that we can deliver power more efficiently. At the same time, we can save millions of dollars and reduce greenhouse gases. So when you join IEOR, you will have a chance to study among almost more than 100 different classes. So we cover many of the following topics in optimization, stochastics, probability, machine learning, supply chain services, financial engineering, and so on and so forth. We are actually a small department compared to the other top 10 IEOR programs in the country. We are the smallest, but we have excellent faculties in the department. And roughly speaking, the faculty can be divided into three research areas. But nowadays, we are doing joint research together, and we apply this methodology in optimization, stochastic, and supply chains, and apply them to the following industry, including healthcare and energy and logistic automation, and also contribute to the algorithm discovery in machine learning. We also have six wonderful IEOR staff. Chini will be the one who you will interact a lot during your 4 years here. So Jenny is in charge of the undergraduate student advising. Diana works in the front office. Kit is on communications and medium. And Rebecca is the department manager. James, if you have any question about IT and computer, you should talk to James. Heather actually mainly works for graduate student advising. Berkeley have more than 1,200 student organizations, and IEOR have two main student groups. The first one is IISE, Institute of Industrial and Systems Engineering. And then we also have our owner society, Alpha Pi Mu. So it's really fun to work with, from the department chair point of view, it's really been fun to work with them because they really help the department to arrange many fun activities. And they are really engaged. I really appreciate all their helps. So they will be helping the department planning social events. They'll help you with internship and job panels. And then they also organize academic conferences. And then they also contact the former students from the department. And then the alum will come back and share with you their working experience and the lessons they learned. So I really encourage you to take a look at these two student society and join them as soon as possible. So when you graduate from IEOR, roughly speaking, we have three major type of jobs you can take on. The first one is really on manufacturing, service, and transportation companies. So many of our students work for UPS, Toyota, Ford, Dell, Boeing, FedEx, and Disney, as I mentioned earlier, and so on and so forth. Also, many of being in Silicon Valley, many of our students actually work for high-tech companies such as Google, Apple, Facebook, Uber, Tesla, Amazon, Salesforce and so on and so forth. So many of the job titles you will have after graduation will be data scientist, industrial engineer, industrial manager, these kind of titles. Also, many of our students would work for financial firms, banks, and consulting firms. So this is a survey from 2018. 77% of our students immediately find a job before graduation, actually. And 23% of them decided to attend grad school to get a PhD or a master's degree. I want to mention that we also have a really good five-year BS MS program. So if you stay one more year, you'll have a chance to get a master's degree from the department. The average starting salary for our students is around 77,000. And the following data is for the whole engineering school. We don't have exact data for IEOR, but I think we actually will be more than this. Each student probably will have two or three jobs easily in their hands. So here is a list of companies that our student has found job from. So here you can see that there are many big firms. And we also have some students who actually became CEO and founders of many interesting companies. So I mentioned Tony Xu. We also have a long list of students who became, who've been selected as top 30 and 30 CEOs. So many of our students would also be really successful in applying their IEOR knowledge to have a company. And if you decided to go on for a graduate degree, many of our graduate students actually became professors at top universities. For example, in recent years, we have graduate students who became professors at Columbia, London Business School, MIT, McGill, Purdue, Stanford, USC, UCLA, Oxford, and many universities in Asia and other parts of the country, of the world. And here are the list of companies that students work on in biotech industry. So Bayer, Genentech, and in consulting of Boston Consulting, ZS Associate, McKinsey. And here are the companies that are related to energy, utility, and government. And here is a list of companies for finance and insurance, logistics, startups. I've mentioned Mixbook. The CEO has been not only really successful, but also has been contributing back to the department quite a bit. And here is the list of the high-tech companies. Okay, so being at UC Berkeley and being close to Silicon Valley, I really open doors for you. Many of the CEOs and leadership from the Silicon Valley companies are Berkeley students, graduate. So they are looking forward to hire most Berkeley students. So it really will help you if you're trying to find a job in Silicon Valley. Here we have amazing weather. For those of you who are not from the Bay Area, we have a really pleasant summer. And the winter time, we don't see snow. If you want to see snow, you have to go to Lake Tahoe. And we have 256 days of sunshine and beautiful sunset. These are the real pictures. I think kids have taken at Berkeley. And during the weekend, there are so many things you can do. I will give you a famous quote from Clark Kerr. If you don't know Clark Kerr, you should try to study the history of UC Berkeley. He mentioned that if you are bored with Berkeley, you are bored with life. So basically that means that you won't get bored. At Berkeley, there are so many things you can do. You can go to the city, You can go to Lake Tahoe. They have so many great food in Berkeley, in San Francisco. There are so many sports activities going on. We have a pretty good football program this year. And then you can even go to the wild, go to Redwood and many other state and national parks to enjoy the nature. If you want to go a little bit further, you can go to Las Vegas, Yosemite, and LA. And the Big Sur area is one of my favorite weekend tour place. At UC Berkeley, being a student here, you enjoy free passes to the gym, to the bus, to the city, and you can have many free software from the campus. And there are many travel benefits and many other benefits you will figure out once you join Berkeley. I will briefly talk about the classes you will be taking at Berkeley. Professor Rob Leachman, who is our undergraduate advisor, will give you a little bit more details during the Cal Day. So during freshman year, you will take two reading and composition courses. You'll take Math 1A, 1B, a computer science class, Physics 7A, a chemistry class, or some other science class, and engineering breadth courses. Sophomore year, you will be taking Math 53, 54, Finance and Engineering Economics, E120, and Physics 7B. And you will also take another computer science class, two engineering breadth courses, and two humanity and social studies courses. We have so many fun electives in the department. IEOR 130 all the way up to 171. And then, you know, we'll be teaching production, decision analysis, supply chain, machine learning, robotics, and organizational design. So when you go to your junior year, you'll be able to take three IEOR electives, and then you have to take some core courses, IEOR 160, optimization, 162 linear programming, and 165 engineering statistical analysis. 172 is probability and risk analysis. And also 173, maybe more on simulation. And two humanity and social study electives. In your senior year, you will take four IEOR electives and five technical electives. Most importantly, you will have a chance to take IEOR 180. That's a senior design, senior project class. You will be able to work with a faculty member to solve a real-world problem by applying what you have learned from IEOR in the 4 years you are here. We also have actually offer a pretty popular ORMS major, meaning Operations Research and Management Science major in Latin Science. And then here you have to take Math 1A, 1B, 53, 54, Engineering 7, Econ 123, and BA 10. And then for ORMS major, you also have to take some electives. You know, there are some non-engineering electives, probably for humanity social study courses. Engineering breadth courses, you need to take three. And then there are some other technical courses you can take, five courses. You can take them related to supply chain, entrepreneurship, design, business and economics, mathematics, computer science, and behavioral sciences. So due to the limited time, I will stop here, but I do hope to have the chance to interact with many of you. You can find my email address from the Berkeley website, so you can reach out to me if you have any questions about the department. And I'm looking forward to meet and interact with you in the fall semester. Thank you.